Cowboys defensive end DeMarcus Lawrence, after Sunday's loss to the Eagles, he clarified his statements a day later on a call with reporters, in part stating this: "I don't feel like the direction is lost. I feel like sometimes the focus is lost. Everybody on the team, everybody in this fan base need to look themselves in the mirror and ask themselves, are they really here for the Cowboys, or are they really here to just blame on each other?" Guys, we've all heard the old adage, football is the ultimate team sport. Max, do you like, love, or hate these comments?
I hate them. First of all, I'm with Stephen A. on this one, unfortunately. I'm here for the accident. I'm waiting for the accident to happen. But
Merry Christmas to you, too.
Thank you. Thank you. Were you here for the Cowboys to place blame?
Yeah.
I hate that comment. Come on, man. How about we need to give our fans something to cheer for? We need to give our fans something to gloat about instead of basically begging the fan base for help. Come on, because the way it comes out, he's trying to talk about accountability for everyone, but it comes out like finger pointing to the fans. You know, the fans don't have to look at themselves and say, are we really here for the Cowboys? Nah, man. The fans show up and say, we paid our money. Let's see something. Give us something. And if what you're giving them is losses and disappointment, you turn on TV and have to see this guy cackling at you.
Yeah, every day.
That's not when a star player, when the best player on the defense says, hey, the fans have to ask themselves, are they really here for, you know, the fans are there for whatever the hell they want. They paid their money. They pay your salary. No, don't beg the fans for help. Say something like, we need to do better for our fans all over the world. We got to give them something to cheer about. So, yeah, I hate to.
But Stephen A., he didn't just say fans. He said everybody on this team.
Yeah. Well, listen, I didn't mind his comments so much. What I mind is the timing of it. Talk about being late to the party. And DeMarcus Lawrence, let me say this to you, my brother, on Christmas Day, because I wish him nothing but the best. He's a Pro Bowler. We know that he's a stud. We know that you can play or whatever. In the last 7 games, you have a half a sack. A half a sack. Now, that wouldn't matter that much if you wasn't opposed to the franchise tag and ultimately got a $105 million contract in the offseason. One could argue you part of the problem. Because guess what? That Dallas Cowboys defense hasn't been that impressive for the most part. We've seen them crumble a little bit. We've seen losses to Minnesota. We've seen how they performed against Chicago. We've seen how they performed against other teams. You're a 7-8 team. Your best situation is you ending up 500 at the end of a season that you were predicted to win at least 11 games. You are the face of that defense, along with Jalen Smith, along with Leighton Vander Esch, who's been injured and obviously out for the season and what have you. But the bottom line is, you're that dude. $65 million in guaranteed dollars, $105 million, and you wait until you lose to the Philadelphia Eagles, no longer control your own destiny, and for all intent and purposes, you come out talking about what we need to do now? Where the hell have you been? Not just with your mouth. Not just with your rhetoric, not just with your inspirational so-called motivational words, but your game. Because we don't expect to see DeMarcus Lawrence have half a sack over the last 7
half
games.
Half a season.
But let me play devil's advocate here, because there has been a lot of finger pointing. Is it Dak? Does Dak deserve the contract? Jason Garrett needs to go. It's the media. It is the fans. And apparently it's within the team, too, where everybody's just pointing fingers rather than trying to put together a solution.
I get it. And look, you know, you say something and you just throw the fans in there. And maybe what he meant to say about the fans was like, we're all in this together. But the way I heard that, the way it came across to me is in the same breath that a guy is trying to talk about accountability, basically, it feels like, it smells like finger pointing. And that's the exact opposite of what you want to do.
I don't have a problem with him saying you could have all the talent. Talent without direction is nothing at all, because that's clearly an indictment against the coach and the front office. That's basically what you're saying, because you have no direction. Whose responsibility is it to provide direction? It's the coach and the people above the coach, which is the GM, the owner, who happens to be the same person in Jerry Jones. And we can't absolve Stephen Jones from this equation as well. All I'm trying to say is this. If you know you've had half a sack in the last 7 games, after signing for $105 million and $65 million in guaranteed dollars, if you're going to make a statement like this, shouldn't that have occurred before the Eagles game? Shouldn't have occurred before the game before that? Or before the game before that? Where have you been?
You know, if all these players are underperforming, like you look at Zeke, and he doesn't get enough touches, and DeMarcus Lawrence and half a sack and half a season, basically, and all those things, and the question is, did we overrate the talent, or is the coaching staff not putting them in the positions they need to be in to succeed?
Well, you just heard him. Dallas Cowboys have Super Bowl-caliber talent.
Seems that way.
But the personnel, the leadership that they have in place, we all know the accident is imminent.
Yeah, but listen, they had a chance to clinch the division. They have to win this week, and the Eagles lose to make the playoffs. And they're talking about focus is an issue. If you're not focused now, when are you ever going to be?
How could you bring up focus now? Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.